Ryan Tannehill has made a shocking rise to become one of the league's best quarterbacks over the last year and a half. As a result, the Tennessee Titans have risen as one of the top teams in the NFL. Tannehill was previously labeled a bust in a 2012 NFL draft littered with real busts. Back at the draft, the Miami Dolphins took Tannehill, but who was taken ahead of him? First, I'd like to acknowledge that the majority of the people who watch our videos aren't subscribed to the channel. Help us out by subscribing and joining us on our way to 100K, because it's coming fast and you don't want to miss out on your opportunity to enlist in the J&D Army. First, let's take a look at the wild rise of Ryan Tannehill. Ryan Timothy Tannehill III was born on July 27, 1988 in Lubbock, Texas. Tannehill attended Big Spring High School in Big Spring, Texas. He played basketball, ran track and field, and played both defensive back and quarterback for the Steers. As a junior, Tannehill passed for 2,510 yards and rushed for 922 yards. Then during his senior season, he passed for 5,258 yards and rushed for 217 yards. Tannehill was named to district second team in both years. He was considered a three-star recruit coming out of high school and decided to commit to play at Texas A&M University. Tannehill decided to redshirt his first season with the Aggies. He wanted to play quarterback, but ended up recording 844 yards and 5 touchdowns at wide receiver. He was named an All-12 honorable mention after recording 609 yards and 4 touchdowns the following season. Tannehill finally got his shot at quarterback as a junior. He had 143 yards and a touchdown after playing 9 games at wide receiver. He was soon after named the starter at quarterback and went on to be named an All-Big 12 honorable mention after passing for 1,638 yards and 13 touchdowns to 6 interceptions. Tannehill played his only full season at quarterback as a senior and impressed with 3,744 yards and 29 touchdowns to 15 interceptions. At the 2012 NFL Draft, the Miami Dolphins selected Tannehill with the 8th pick. The Dolphins were horrible during his first 4 seasons and failed to put together a winning season until his 5th year when Miami made the playoffs. Finally, things looked up for Tannehill, but he then suffered a torn ACL and missed the following season. He returned in 2018, but struggled and missed 5 games with a shoulder injury. Labeled a bust, Tannehill went 42-46 with 20,434 yards and 123 touchdowns to 75 interceptions before Miami decided to trade him away to the Tennessee Titans. Titans starter Marcus Mariota struggled to start the season in 2019, and Tannehill ended up stepping in and thriving in Tennessee, going 7-3 and passing for 2,742 yards and 22 touchdowns to 6 interceptions. In the playoffs, the Titans surprised the league by blowing by the Patriots and Ravens en route to making the AFC Championship. Tannehill was named Comeback Player of the Year and signed a huge 4-year, $118 million contract this offseason. The Titans have dominated to start 2020 and are 5-2 behind Tannehill, passing for 1,823 yards and 17 touchdowns to only 3 interceptions. Tannehill has beat the odds in the NFL, but how about those taken before him? With the first overall pick at the 2012 NFL Draft, the Indianapolis Colts selected Stanford quarterback Andrew Luck. The hype around Luck was astronomical, and he is widely considered one of the greatest quarterback prospects of all time. Suck for Luck was the movement everyone was in on, and the Colts won it. His career started off extremely promising, and he led the Colts to an 11-5 record over his first 3 seasons, making the Pro Bowl each season along the way. Over the span, Luck passed for 12,957 yards and 86 touchdowns to 43 interceptions, and even led the league in touchdowns in 2014. Early in his career, his line was extremely bad, and that began to hurt him in 2015 when he suffered a lacerated kidney and a torn abdominal muscle. Luck returned to health in 2016, but had shoulder surgery after the season and missed the 2017 season. He again returned from injury and was even named Comeback Player of the Year while making the Pro Bowl in 2018. Everything looked up for Luck. That was until he shocked the football world and decided to retire the following offseason due to his piling up of injuries. He was 20-18 with 10,714 yards and 85 touchdowns to 45 interceptions after his first 3 seasons in the league. Luck is one of the few two stars to retire in the prime of their career when he stepped away at only 29 years old. The Washington Redskins own the second selection, where they took Baylor quarterback Robert Griffin III. RG3 had a rookie season to remember, and I remember it well as a Washington fan. He led the Redskins to 7 straight victories to finish the season and land in a playoff spot. He was named the Offensive Rookie of the Year and made the Pro Bowl. He passed for 3,200 yards and 20 touchdowns to 5 interceptions, along with 815 rushing yards and 7 touchdowns. RG3 was becoming one of the league's best, but in the wildcard round against the Seahawks, he injured his knee that forced him to have surgery. The injury was a follow-up after he sprained his LCL in Week 14, and head coach Mike Shanahan still decided to play him. From here, the walls began closing in on Griffin. He didn't perform well in 2013 after leading the Redskins to a 3-10 record and recording 3,203 yards and 16 touchdowns to 12 interceptions to go with 489 rushing yards. He ended up getting benched in favor of Kirk Cousins and was injured in Week 2 of 2014 after suffering a dislocated ankle. RG3 returned to the starting role and had 1,694 yards and 4 touchdowns to 6 interceptions. That was enough for Washington to decide to inactivate RG3 for all of 2015 before releasing him. He played a season with the Cleveland Browns after and went 1-4 with 886 yards and 2 touchdowns to 3 interceptions. After a year away from the gridiron, RG3 signed with the Baltimore Ravens in 2018 and still remains there. In Baltimore, RG3 is 1-0 and has 255 yards and 1 touchdown to 3 interceptions. Third overall, the Cleveland Browns drafted Alabama running back Trent Richardson. Richardson was an impressive prospect, and the Browns even traded up to ensure they got him. Much like many decisions the Browns have made in the last decade, it didn't work out. Richardson is considered one of the biggest draft busts of this century. He did well as a rookie with 950 yards and 11 touchdowns. He even debuted on the NFL Top 100 list at number 71. However, his yards per carry was a poor 3.6 yards per attempt, the lowest of all rookie running backs. Richardson suited up for 2 games in 2013 for the Browns before he was surprisingly traded to the Indianapolis Colts, where he had a rough 3.1 yards per carry. Richardson played one more season with Indianapolis before being waived. He had 1,082 yards and 6 touchdowns after his rookie year. Richardson hasn't returned to the NFL field, but has made his way around in short stops with the Oakland Raiders and Baltimore Ravens before spending time with the CFL's Saskatchewan Roughriders and the AAF's Birmingham Iron. USC offensive tackle Matt Khalil was taken fourth by the Minnesota Vikings. Khalil is from a big football family. His father, Frank, was drafted by the Buffalo Bills in 1982, and his brother, Ryan, is a 3-time All-Pro and 5-time Pro Bowl selection. Matt made the Pro Bowl every season during his first 3 years of his career. He later became the highest-paid center in NFL history after signing a 5-year, $55 million deal with the Carolina Panthers. Khalil was a solid staple on both the Vikings and Panthers offensive line, but unfortunately suffered a shoulder injury and later a neck injury that forced him to retire after the 2018 season. He did come out of retirement in 2019 and played with the New York Jets, but he did ultimately just land on injured reserve. With the 5th overall pick, the Jacksonville Jaguars selected Oklahoma State wide receiver Justin Blackmon. Richardson was a huge whiff, but he wasn't the only major bust picked in the top 5. Before ever stepping on an NFL field, Blackmon was already arrested for driving under the influence. He was released and then ended up recording 865 yards and 5 touchdowns as a rookie. Then, after 4 games in 2013, he was arrested for marijuana possession. He had 415 yards and a touchdown in those 4 games. Blackmon was denied reinstatement from the league in 2015 and was then arrested for DUI again and sentenced to a year in jail. He is no longer on probation as of August 2017. The Dallas Cowboys own the 6th selection, where they took LSU cornerback Morris Claiborne. Claiborne was a surprising riser after not being considered a top talent in the draft before making huge strides in his junior season in college. The Cowboys loved Claiborne and decided to trade up to ensure they got him. And well, it didn't go well. He missed 26 games over his final 3 seasons in Dallas, recording 151 tackles and 4 interceptions along the way. He then made a living on 1-year deals after back-to-back years with the New York Jets and spending time with the Kansas City Chiefs in 2019, where he did secure a Super Bowl ring. He had 114 tackles and 3 interceptions since leaving Dallas. Claiborne is currently a free agent. Seventh overall, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers drafted Alabama safety Mark Barron. Barron started at strong safety early in his career and was named to the PFWA All-Rookie Team. The Buccaneers brought in a new head coach in Lovie Smith in 2014, and Barron was ultimately shipped off to the St. Louis Rams for picks due to his unprofessional behavior. Barron was a backup early in his time with the Rams before finding himself at a new position, weak side linebacker, where he made a living for five seasons, recording 380 tackles, 7 sacks, and 5 interceptions. Barron had 82 tackles and 3 sacks with the Pittsburgh Steelers in 2019 and is currently employed with the Denver Broncos. And finally, with the 8th selection at the 2012 NFL Draft, the Miami Dolphins took Texas A&M quarterback Ryan Tannehill. The draft was littered with busts, and Tannehill was said to be one of them for quite some time. But in a new era with the Tennessee Titans, Tannehill has flipped the script and become one of the game's best. Thanks for watching. Follow us on Instagram and Twitter for more J&D. We read all of our DMs and love hearing what y'all have to say.